Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you. Just calm down. I know. I was doing NHL, but I decided to do a fear mongering radio. And shout out to Melissa. Accept the apology. We spoke on the phone. Appreciate the conversation with the young lady. We made amends for my poor, filthy, dirty behavior. She may call the show. We have stalker news, the big wedding tomorrow. I guess one of them, I guess. I don't know if he hit it or he lost it. I have no idea. Don't care. She's making them, I guess. I don't, you know, I mean, I don't know if it was body or whatever the hell happened. I have no, I don't care. Who knows? But anyways, so one soccer still out there. Getting their big wedding tomorrow anyways. It is what it is. So it is. Will always be. Bitch, please. I mean, bitch, please. Let me see what you're doing. Hang on a second. Super Bowl. Here we go. Perfect. But yes. It's your favorite audio addiction. Fear mongering radio. Here on YouTube on the Cowpoke Podcast. Oh, all kinds of dogs and kitties. Oh, I can't get it. Once I start watching Prison and everything else, I'm watching some movie clips. We're over there looking on my channel, Lovely and Talented. Cowpoke Advantage. We'll talk about it. The video's coming out tomorrow. I'm talking about the wedding. Did Mr. Beast drama, Helping People See. That's done from the studio. I did one adventure. What's this, babe? What's this music creative? What's this all about? Bring your video new life with creator music. What the hell is this all about? I don't need that. I already have all this stuff. Let me see. Don't tell me they took away the music. Don't tell me they did that. I can't believe they did that. No way. Maybe it went over a different way, but let me see. It better not. Did you take away the music? Really? Did you take away the music? Oh, my word. No. More tracks, no charge. The hell is this all about? Revenue share, I don't need all that. Get started. I mean, why in the hell am I all of a sudden getting all this stuff featured, sharing tracks? What the hell? Featured license tracks? Moods, bright, happy, funky, chill, uplifting. I don't know why all of a sudden it's what I can't. I don't want all this. The hell? I don't understand this. Am I no music anymore? What the hell? Oh, come on. You have got to be kidding. We used to have all the good musics. So where do we get the... this bums me out. Mm-hmm. See, this is... I have no idea this is. Okay. Well, this kind of sucks. I don't want this. Okay, I don't understand this. But anyways, your library. What the hell is this all about? No slave tracks. Browse. Mood. I just want sad. I don't give a crap. Let me see. I don't understand. Match. I don't understand this. Don't understand what the hell this is all about. What the hell's going on here? I guess. Unless they start singing again. Because you used to be able to put songs to stuff. Whatever. I don't understand. Mm-hmm. So we'll just kind of look at this and... Anyways, welcome to the show. It's weird. I'm sorry. They took away the songs. I don't need all that behavior. Hang on a second. We're going to go over here. I apologize. This is really strange. It's too bad, man. God, you want to put music on your stuff? Now you're kind of screwed if you want to do something. So hang on a second here. I'm going to go over to my, relax. I just want to put music. All I want to do is put music in the background. That's all I want to do. Here we go. Let's go over here. I'm sorry. Sorry about this, guys. So all I want to do, let's do this. That's strange. There we go. Anyway, I don't know why all of a sudden it's doing that, but it kind of takes all the fun out of it. Anyway, so this is just background music, copyright free music. Anyways, walk the show. It was Jeff, Fearmongering Radio. We appreciate you coming to the show. Sorry about the intro, but I don't know what the hell. I saw some email on the music stuff, and I didn't really think it was a big deal, but it is what it is. Go look where you all come from, Fearmongering Radio. We appreciate everybody coming. There's 2 million things you can listen to out there, and we appreciate everybody coming. It's been consistent. I got a couple today from Spotify and Siobhan out there in India. You guys loving India. And you're kind of slacking off there a little bit on sources and Giovanni geolocations in India. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times for me out there. I'll come and see you guys. You get more. I'll come see. Really, India. I'd come see. I want to go overseas. I want to go to Greek islands too as well. Geolocation, United States, Texas, Minnesota, Oklahoma, New York, New York. New York, Flushing. But he shall not be named. Call the show, Sven Johnson. Chandler, California, Los Angeles, Sacramento, Lake Forest. In Georgia, Atlanta. Up in Virginia, Roanoke. In Minnesota, it's Minneapolis, Hopkins, San Diego, Richmond, Hinckley, and Minnetonka. Thank you, Minnesotans. Of course, the stalkers in full regalia. Never ends there. He has listened 10 times. Thank you, stalker. I appreciate it. But we appreciate everybody that comes to the show. I really do. A lot of different sources that come in, and Apple Podcasts, and I have New Guinea, and Israel, Sweden, Australia, Canada, Mexico, South Africa, and Zimbabwe. Where the hell is Zimbabwe? Whatever. Thank you very, very much. Appreciate me on Yahoo. Sorry about the intro there, but I don't know, weird. We're Cowpote Radio on Twitter. We have the Cowpote Adventures. We've been doing some videos. I'll get real quick, but I always make sure we thank the military men and the armed forces. We do appreciate you storming those beaches. We thank you. That was a little nothing at all. The Air Force, the Army, and the Marines, and the Navy, and the Merchant, and NASCAR Coast Guard, they're in and out of uniform. Thank you so much. I appreciate all that you guys do. Without you, World War II, I'm not speaking English. We had Korea and the Vietnam, Afghanistan, all that stuff. The draft dodgers out there, Bill Clinton and Donald J. that send people to war. Okay? So we appreciate you guys. And make good choice. You are who you run with on this video platform. You are who you are. It's all there is to it. You're going to stalk, you're going to stalk. I get it. You want to stalk, by all means. I reconnected with an old friend, and she accepted my apology, and we spoke on the phone, hashed it out. She didn't have to, but she did, and I appreciate it very, very much. Appreciate it, young lady. We discussed a few things and got a few things out of the way, and I told her she can call the show. Good to connect with a fun young lady of her stature. So thank you, sweet Melissa, for accepting my apology in a video. So thank you, sweetheart. Anyways, so, and you're going to have sex, that's fine. Just simply put a condom on, put the 12 pills. That's all you got to do. Put one on. Taco Monday. Have a rare Monday. The NFL's over. I have one more show I got to do for the post game. Chickens win. I was listening to Stalker. I did the breakdown of the car. That'll come out tonight. Tomorrow's a big wedding for those two. I could break it down here right now, but an upset. It was a 2-point kick coming either way. Chris Ransom took KC. I knew numerous people that took KC. So it's like it was not an upset. Upset's 10 points. That's an upset. It was almost a pick-up in theory. I mean, either way, it did. The stalker is still calling my cell phone nonstop, running around with a mentally challenged young lady who ran away from home and, controlling her. It's too bad. Snuggles deserves better, but when you're controlled by a guy who's being groomed to be a gay man, and watching man-on-man sex. Fact. So I feel sorry for her. He's using her mental deficiencies for sex, and God forbid he knocks her up like a cheerleader. But when you have nothing better to do. But we've been doing those Samsung videos. I love doing. They're fun. I did I did the video on the one guy who did the help see Mr. Beast. He was in the YouTube. He was in the commercial in my studio. It was kind of cool. I did it. I do more of it in the studio. I have videos out to April 2nd, and we've been doing adventures here and there. I've been doing some editing. I'm gonna edit a video on my phone. My last weekend. Getting my hat. Anyways, but yes. So, being stalked. I don't put their names in there. Don't mention one. Not worthy of it, but running around with a young lady who's mentally challenged is not a cool thing. But, look who he's running with. You can control people. And pretty soon, like I said, it's man on man. And pretty soon, he's, it's just a fact. You're a stalker. It's the way it is. I don't put his name in there. But you get called over and over again, over and over again. It's like, that ship has sailed, sweetheart. He's getting married tomorrow. Justice of the Peace. And we're partied on Fat Boy Country. So I went to the Mall of Astoria this weekend to get a hat. You two in red, Cowport Adventures, right? Guy wrote it down. I said, I want it stacked. 1, 2, 3, right? Okay, he spells adventures and kind of, I go, you know how to spell, right? Oh, yeah. So I come on Sunday to get it, right? He throws me a hat, and I go, no. He had YouTube, and then Cowport Adventures, one whole word. No. I said, no. You go YouTube, Cowport Adventures, and the back Cowport Podcast, the back of the hat. $70 because I'm getting it kind of done differently. That's not the point. He's the general manager. I'll take care of it. So I go there today. I go down 35W, cruise over there, get over there, can't find it. She comes out and I go, no, that's not my, I said, that's the one he screwed up on. All right? I'm like, Jesus Christ. So they call the guy. Oh, I didn't do it. So she walks over the machine, right? Gets the YouTube, gets the cowpot. And she gets the YouTube cowboy and then adventures. I said no. She misspells adventures. I said, you know how to spell adventures? Listen, I said. So she gets on her phone. So she knows. I said, you know how to spell it now? Yes. This is an adventure. Kind of looked at me. I'm like, come on, man. This is a very rational thing that you're doing right here. I looked at you. You understand that, right? Yes. It's getting to be irrational. What I'm my thoughts right now. I'm getting pissed. I don't get mad at a lot of things. I don't. I'm really easy going on customer. I understand. I work in public, but the incompetency. So then she turns the hat on for a couple of podcasts, and I go, it's one word. She looked at me. She's from down south. It's one word. We've been through that behavior. I'm like, Jesus Christ. I'm an idiot who couldn't spell podcast. I'm sorry. It's one word. No excuse. So when I get the hat, I was filming all week long, going to the mall, kind of swimming around. I had another one I did before. It's coming up later. When I went down to the casino to bet on the Super Bowl, that's kind of late. Kind of cool on the phone. I'm working with iMovies just to put together. I'm not putting music to put together and be done with it. That's what I'm doing. Okay? So have some fun there. I'm not over-edit, but... It's fun on the phone, just done. I don't need to do all the crap on it. So I'll put all that together. Just the final video will be when I get my ass over there, and I'll put it up. And me, Super Bowl, cooking the food. It's just a fun little video. Whatever, how long it's going to be, 20 minutes. I try to keep it as best I can, but when you're screwing around, whatever it may be, I'm going to... Say as a dude now, I say whatever. I know that these people, these 30-minute videos, keep it to 20 or 15. So, anyway, like, Jesus Christ, man. How stupid are we here? So, that's just like when they made my fear-mongering radio. He misspelled it. I said, I told you. I looked at the guy, I said, no. It's not how you spell fear-mongering. It's something different. They don't know how to do it. I mean, it's adventure. Just spell it, for Christ's sake. Look it up, bitch boy. And you try to pronounce. Don't try to pronounce cow. Just it's the way I spell it. It's cowpo, moron. Oh my god. It's like, oh my god. But it is what it is, man. It's like, sometimes you just want to go smoke some geef and get real high than a draft's ass and maybe go venture into some man on man, you know, and just work on that behavior. Hey, $20 is $20, you know. You're going to pitch, you're going to catch, bitch boy, right? Bitch, please. But yeah, I'm still being stalked. I don't know what happened to the other, if his fiance's channel hit, I really don't care, don't know. You know, I don't know. It's whatever it may be. He probably made another channel somewhere. I don't know what happened. Because I know he was, if he was bodying the channel, he was unbodying. I mean, I had people make, one of the trolls, one of the stalkers was making channel, my went up. I don't really care. You know, it doesn't mean squad. I'm working on 1900 over there on the Adventure channel. It doesn't mean anything. Yeah, you get monetized. Again, that means absolutely nothing. Nothing. Okay, nothing at all. Let's go look. I mean, okay, over here on Spreaker.com. Let's look at Spreaker.com. Again, I've talked before about these behaviors of you want to make money. You know, New World Order has gotten a lot of downloads. It's been pretty funny over there. It's, you know, Peter, if you got a little peto, I responded on the one he was over there on the stalker. You know, the next one coming up. It's going to be about 60, 50, 60 bucks. Again, you want to make money at doing this internet crap, you won't make any money on YouTube. I don't care how. Again, if you have to, if it's Wonder Hussy or any of the people I know, the Daily Woo, who people just stalk this guy. Just, they watch the video, everything out of it. It's amazing these people I've listened to that literally stalk these YouTubers. Hey, I like Wonder Hussy. I do. And I don't really like, what's his name anymore? I used to. He's just become just a total troll. The hell's his name again? Carpetbagger. But the guy begging for money, everything else, and I get it, that's what you want to do, go for it, but it's nonstop skullduggery, right? If you can't carry your own behaviors, and if you have money, look for money, then you should just pack it in, as far as I'm concerned. So, in the last 28 days, I've got 11,000 views, great watch time, 146, estimated venue, $7. The deep dish one, and I know TikTok is when I get my when I go over to put a video up, you know, the 30 stuff, 50, so what? I'm worried about the money I put in my hands this weekend. That's what I'm worried about. I mean, my good money for stalking the East Coast, 159, not a big deal. 5 likes. I'm almost up to 1,900 subs, getting close to 2,000. Great. Do my views count it? No. So we've made so far. In the last 28 days, I'll have a live count. Yes, yeah, so what? I mean, mainly all my shorts are the big ones, but I mean, I have other ones. The Deadpool one is 149. So the last 28 days, the Elvis one has always gotten pretty. That one, I did the thing, so I'll take 2,000-3,000 at a time. That's fine. When I was up on the second, I'm going down now. Kind of right now, because I peaked for a while. Now it's gone back down. I get it, you know. It kind of goes up. In the last year, because I got to do my thing, I made $130.37. Great. I'm happy for you. Chum change what I make at the airport, right? Views, 218,000. Watch time, 21K. And then I'm plus 302 this year. Great. All right, cool. Appreciate it. So people that decided to come and listen to the show, I appreciate it. So 1,200 views the last 48 hours. Thanks. Appreciate it. It's just kind of cool to look at all this stuff and audience. Let's look at the audience real quick. I think it's kind of cool. Let me see. Mainly all men. United States, India, 7%, United Kingdom, Indonesia, and Canada. Let me see what else I got coming my way. Let me see what else. Spain, Japan. Views, I get a lot. So it always on Israel. I got 210. So it's the main one, obviously, is the United States, and then India, and then United. So I appreciate Indonesia, India. They love me. They love you in India. So I appreciate those guys coming over all the time too, as well. So Appreciate it very, very much. So, yeah, it's kind of fun to look at the thing here. So, hi, cowboy. You have 8 new notifications. You got no, yeah, so what? Your contest, no, it's not exciting, for Christ's sake. It's not exciting. Go, that's, what's the big deal? Let's go look. Oh, boy, it's so exciting, me putting up, I just put up whatever I decided to put up. Shrimp and steak, $2.91. I love Cheetos. Costco, Venture Boat, yes or no. That was the night when those guys got triggered when I changed my channel. Giving up option for whatever, the girls, you know. I mean, 250, whatever. I don't, you know. Some people get real excited about viral videos. They really do. Especially on TikTok or YouTube. It's like my favorite of the people that are the, what do you want to call those idiots? What do they call the influence? I want to influence you to a job. That's how I want to influence you. I don't give a crap about some people doing dumb videos. I want something funny like a cat or dog video. Yeah, I don't need to hear that behavior. I could care less. Zero fucks given. But anyways, just kind of, I don't know, I figured I wouldn't lay down and be wasted. I enjoy doing what I'm doing. I enjoy podcasting. It's a lot of fun. I did a video on Chloe's channel. Let's go look at the kid behind the camera. Let's see what he's doing these days. People still love this guy. Fighting in Costco, 1 hour. I thought he did that already. It was at Walmart. Let me see. Again, too long of a video. Angry Grandpa, Little Caesars. Only 89K. Only 89K. That's sad. Angry Grandpa Lil's. He's dead. I wonder if AGP's grave. Let's see if there's an AGP. AGP grave. Grave. Let me go. AGP. Angry Grandpa. Let's see. Oh, no. Okay. Where is the grave of Angry Grandpa? Lamont at large. Oh, the Lamont at large. He only did that 9 months ago. So here we are. Happy Mother's Day. So it looks like the Angry Grandpa show. So, hardest failure day of my life. His dad went there again. I'm sorry. Keep behind the camera 10 years ago. Rest in peace. So, people are looking at Gray. So, I still just see Savage apologize for saying he didn't have cancer. So, where is the grave of Angry Grandpa? Lamont at large. He runs around all the time. So, that's what I see on here. So, buried alive prank. So anyway, he's dead, but I don't think Savage has ever apologized for her behavior. Live media makes me laugh. Let's see what she's been doing. Messy Monday. She's never apologized. I love, you know, I remember I called her out. You stay off my time. We followed each other. Hey, she's got 13,000 subs. She's getting 2,000 per 1.4. I still like the Christmas one, but that was embarrassing. The TikTok, the one she did, the children, the one she did, that was another 1,000. That was an embarrassing video. She prostituted that African American, literally pimped him. That was embarrassing. I called her on that one. That was a disgusting embarrassment. Really? Go give some money to Mercy Ship. That was just a girl. Like I said, I get it. I don't get that much either, but she's 3,000 here. It's way, you know. Too big. It's supposed to be media. So I talk about media. I don't know. Whatever. It's just funny as hell. Where's Mrs. F. Wonderful? I'd love to have her on the show. Call the show. Mrs. F. Wonderful. Let's see. What is she doing? She's always fun. Mrs. F. Wonderful lying again. Who cares? 1 month ago, she's lying. What's the worry? She'd be great. Oh, Mrs. F. Wonderful ain't nothing but a gold digger, of course. She'd be great to get some porn video, get her teeth and hair fixed. That's why Savage doesn't like her. Because as soon as she looks like Savage, she gets pissed. So it is what it is. So it's not wonderful. I think she could really be a nice girl, but she's an alcoholic. It's not wonderful. I'm an alcoholic. Okay. Drama snippet. I get it. She'd be a very pretty girl. She'd be very good. She'd be great to put in a movie. She'd be great to have a taste like Chicken Comedy Hour. But it'd be cool. I'm gonna put Wonder Hussy in there. She'd be fun as hell. But Wonder Hussy is a goofy. She'd be fun. Savage is too much. Can't potty mouth. That's the problem. Wonder Hussy would be fun. It'd be fun to run around and do that. It'd be hilarious. Do a chase like chicken with her. So next one in Vegas, I see if I could meet us in Vegas and take us around Vegas. I'll give her $100. I don't want any nudies from you because she would pay you If you would pay her $500, she'd take her on Vegas and this, then you could take pictures of her nude body. Whoopee, up and do. I'm like, really? But yeah, tomorrow is the big wedding for the stalkers. Big, big wedding for them to consummate their marriage, or back together, and they're stalking the usual ways, causing trouble, havoc, running around. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What's this? Lionel hook bids well to fixing holes. What's the lack of winter Olympic bids may lead to resort to fix the holes? AL, some former Justin Miles stole the show at the Super Bowl, whatever. I don't know. But Cellcast fails again as online, whatever's going on there. But yeah, they're gonna get married. And I guess what's his name? That's him. Blind Ambition said that he was bitching about me, about he apologized, whatever else, about Arizona Ingrate, right? The griper, right? And I got a video coming out, you know, that he's a liar, a poor pie rant, also him and Nelly Green, you know, whatever else, penis breath. But he's crazy. A lot of people on here do need, what's that crazy drug called? What do I call it? Not Adderall, that's what Tina, but what's the drug that they, what's the crazy drug? What do they call that stuff? Crazy drug. What is it called? What the hell is that stuff called? Whatever he, not Adderall, but the ones that you take. It's what he is. He's a liar. He's a crazy bastard. So he's a bold-faced little liar. People realize real quick that the Ingrate is just nothing but, what's this? Trump last was all too close to the sicko killers. Former president, so I wanted to report that then another my course had to close the paid him. He agreed to host a third term in the course in North Virginia. Get involved, the LB Tour get wrote. Chris have called the development of the new golf supporting sport washing, meaning that sorry, use cold hard cash sports to event and attempt to wipe out all those nasty quests for the Game of Thrones style public executions, creepy murders, and nettle some journalists who all too closely with the sickle killers who that's right, so true. Yeah, he doesn't care. The hunch, he won't win, trust me. He'll go third party, then you're fucked. Then you're effed. You're screwed. The hunch. That's all I'm saying. But yeah, just kind of ramming around here, you know, you're live here, and it's the Ingrate is a liar. That's all he is. I mean, before he needs to use his drugs, he really does. You know, again, I remember when what's the one that, I love to play it back. It's to have to find it first, but I'm not, it's Pagel's channel, Triggered Minds, and Pagel calls him out. I listened to the other day, and it just literally gets down to the point of what he is. He'll say one thing in drama, I'm done. You know, I think he turned on some chick. It's what he does, man. He's a drama whore. It's all he is. He's a bull-faced little liar. He's just mentally ill. Loves the attention. Look at the cockroach. She does it. Look at he shall not be named. He realized he was wasting his time. He was wasting his time, okay? Plain and simple, so. But G Mango's in the comment. What's her name? Jamie Hicks. So he wants to say sorry. I want to say I'm sorry for the things I said when I was defending AZ and his group. I learned the hard way not to trust him. Well, good. 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 I just made a comment down there from me. That's fine. He called the show. Call the show. Blind Ambition. Because he should do some more live shows. I think he'd be pretty good. He could be a pretty good podcaster. I mean, he's over on Spreaker.com. Do some stuff. What the hell? Have some fun. Do some podcasting. Pay the 45 minute. So that's too bad about the music. That really kind of bums me out. This music behavior, that pisses me off. That was always cool. And I saw Wonder Hussy do a video on that. She was talking about all these, you know, she uses music. And she talked about that. That it's, you know, that you can, she was talking about that. that you have all these different songs. And she did. I totally agree with her on that. That's just too bad. That's stupid as hell. That's too bad. They're getting rid of all that behavior, because it's, you'll be able to, you feature different tracks, browse your library. I don't have any library in there. It's just too bad, man. I loved it, all that stuff. It was cool. Because I don't understand why they changed it. Whatever. I don't get it. I don't need singing either. Let's go chill. See what this is all about. So I don't know how this is all going to work out here. Bones. I don't know. It's too bad. Hang on a second. I'm going to pause for a second. See what this does. I don't want singing. I don't want any singing here. That's cool. Okay. But if they start singing, it'll piss me off. No day, no drop off. See, that's too bad. Because you don't need somebody singing while I'm talking. You don't need that, because that's as crazy as a fox. That's stupid as hell. That's too bad. That's too bad. Whatever. That kind of bummed me off, because when you would, as I said, Wonder Hussy talked about it, that you could pull songs off, and she used a lot of that stuff. I know people do use it. I think you gotta have both. You should be able to have both. I don't know why they're doing that. It's stupid. But whatever. That's just dumb. I'll just use these things on here. On my show here. That's fine. I like certain things, especially when I do New World Order or Aaron the Gangsta. I'll just do Aaron Hernandez without it. But New World Order, I do it too as well. But oh well. You live and you learn, and you learn and you live. It's too bad. It's too bad, but oh well. You live and you learn, and you live and you learn. If the music makes it when you're talking, you can cruise along here. But yeah, you're going to get married tomorrow. It's going to be epic. Steel stalking, calling the phone. Whatever happened to the fiance's channel, I have no idea. Hiding it, I have no idea. Don't care. The way it works, people love to do that behavior. So, but anyways, I don't know what's going on. It's the way she goes. But that's how it is on flight from Hawaii. Plunged within. Ooh, that's not cool. United flight from Hawaii plunged within 800 feet of Pacific. Oh, ooh, my God. That's not good. That's not good. That's not good at all. Not good at all. So it is what it is. But I don't know. I don't get it, but see, right now the stalker's calling, but I'm not going to answer the phone. I'm not going to answer it. He's too ballless. You can kind of hear it, you know, so you can kind of hear that behavior. So then they'll call back again. They call back again and again. Hang on a second. Let me do something else real quick now. But they'll call. They call over and over. That's what they do. So they'll call over and over again. They stalk. I mean, again, running around with some chick who had ran away, I guess. Something in the article. And who's mentally unstable. This isn't cool at all. It's not cool. But it is what it is, man. It's weird. You don't take somebody that's mentally unstable and run around with it. It's not cool. I mean, I've talked to her, but that's just not a cool thing. But you know, that's what when you get upset, people like me, he's obsessed with the food. I get it. Gonna get married, have all the behaviors. I don't know, I don't get it, but it is what it is. I don't know. When you don't work for a living, I don't care who you are out there, not just the stalkers, We got hammered over the weekend. Made some really great money. You know, went and got that hat, and I'm going to get it. You know, every day I have different things I could be doing. I have so many ideas for videos. I wish I had time. I could literally do a video. Who was it that was the Wonder Hussy and the other chick that they, Wandry Gypsy? I think it's impossible to do a video day. It's not that tough. It's not that tough to get in front of a camera and give your opinion. Like I said, I could spend the whole summer down the Oregon coast. I've been out before and do, I could probably give you a video a day of the Oregon. Just say, hey, this is what I'm doing out here. Blah, blah, blah. Thanks. See you tomorrow. I could do Route 66. I'd love to drive. I was watching a video on that the other day. I could drive the loneliest highway. There's all kinds of museums along the way. I'd love to do that. That goes to Utah. I saw a guy with his dad. They have the shoe tree. And it's not that tough to do a video a day and don't over edit. It's not that tough. My GoPro 10, I love it. My DJI, I love my GoPro 10. And I've been doing with my Samsung, my 8-minute video, screwing around with that behavior. You know, people that come listen to me, that's fine. The stalkers, they call you over and over and over and over again. Let's see if I got a message from these idiots. Let's see. Nope, nothing yet. Let's see. Let's see if I got one. Let's see. Let's see if they left a message. Because usually they don't. Not lately, they haven't.
You have 3 saved messages. Saved?
Nope. Thought for sure they would leave a message. Guess not. Too chicken. That's what they do. But he's stalking the room right now. Trust me, he's listening live. But I don't know why you'd hang out. I mean, I get being a friend with a mentally challenged person. There's nothing wrong with that. That's what you do. But it is what it is, you know. So it is what it is. The way she goes, when you call over and over again, and that's just the way she goes, man. But the big wedding tomorrow, and I heard AZ is going to be part of the wedding, I guess. Gonna be part of it, and they're gonna have a gay old time. So again, that's a guy you just can't trust. I'm sorry, I've been saying that all along with him. You cannot trust this guy. He's a con man. He's crazy. Living with his stepdaughter, impregnator, and then the chick pretending to be his wife is nothing but a nurse, okay, or housekeeper, whatever. But that one guy, I told people over and over again, don't trust this guy. Don't trust him. He likes to lie. I lie on purpose to flush out the truth. But these stalkers, these people are on 20 on, 4 off. They don't leave the house. They don't leave the house. I get up at 4:30. I take it for a walk. I go to work. I drove all over the place. My boss is in Hawaii. You want me back by noon? And then someone else was helping out in the warehouse. And I said, no problem. Just get your stuff done, man. You know, recycle some wire today. They didn't want it. It's $200. Where the hell it was? I got steel. I got to bring in. I'd kill myself if I wasn't working. I don't understand how this is your outlet. It's just to me. It's just a fun time. I've never did this to make money, and I enjoy making videos in the car with the Samsung, ripping on people, having fun. You know, but it comes with a cost of stalking. Calling the house, threatening your wife, that kind of behavior. And that's why I gave people just forget it no longer. And yeah, I've apologized, Melissa. We made amends. Okay? We spoke on the phone. Apologies go a long ways. Okay? You know, it's all but people will never apologize on here. They'll say they've never anything wrong, but they forget what they've done. Your past is always your future until you can say, hey, guess what? I was wrong. I'm sorry, blah, blah, blah. But they won't do it. They'll never do it. They'll never, ever do it. They'll never apologize. Because when you're psychotic and you're crazy and mentally ill, you're just, it's like griper. People put my house out on the internet. They put my wife's life into it. And then when you want to, a couple people have done that. And then when you want to take, and you want to have them pay that check. Wow, I didn't do anything. That happened 2 weeks ago. I have a very long memory. As Melissa has said, I know the bodies are buried. And these people will talk a big game, but as soon as you all of a sudden there to cash that check, well, that happened a long time ago. Hey, if I murdered somebody tomorrow, there's no, what we want to call it, statute of limitations in this behavior. People threaten people on here, say stuff. As soon as you want to come back and say something, just like I told with I don't think he'd listen, G Mangos, just block these idiots. Don't say their name. Don't say their name. That pisses them off more than anything else. But that's just weird. These stalkers have just called 3-4 times for my phone. I mean, how many times are you going to call? I mean, for fuck's sake. I mean, God. He's listening live right now. You know, he's nothing better to do. I was telling him the other day, you know, about getting jobs. There's that job over here, over in Woodbury. $60,000 a year starting off running two machines. You can be 120. You can do three. I think he's got 3 12s and 4 10s for sure. Just a nice man. You walk in the break room, whatever you want. But he said they can do it, but they can't get rid of the drugs. People just, when you sit around and become obese and you become tubby and you just smoke dope all day long, I get smoking. I get it. I used to smoke my share of geef. I totally understand that. But my God, you know, you bitch about Biden, but you don't pay taxes. That money better be in it, right? Just get it. I mean, just so much you can do out there. You can work for, hey, what's your name? Melissa. Savage could have had her own, could work for my uncle, making six figure, but no. Let's start to do a bunch of weird shit. Let's troll people. She'd be having a good job. No, she's media stuck on YouTube. It's what she is. It's just, I get it. Man, I get there's other people, Rumbles out there and everything else out there. And I, you know, what's her name? One of their steel-toed charge show went over to Rumble because they got suspended for a week. The stalker didn't know that. That's great. Go over there. No one cares. And to make money, if again, Wonder Hussy was bitching that she was being called an e-beggar. Sweetheart, you're an e-beggar. When you have that thing in there to ask for money, you're an e-beggar. Tell her just to it. What the hell? There we go. Plain and simple. Tell her just to it. You're an e-beggar, sweetheart. I mean, I'm not going to listen to these 30-minute, 25-minute babbling videos. She went the other day. I listened a little bit of it. She went on and on and on. She could have done it in 12. That's what I like about the company, man. Instead of talking with you, I do want to see you be successful. I've sent her emails. I've told her this. Monday, Wednesday. Because she does two of them on back-to-back. And they're just getting like 30,000, some or more. But she would do it Monday, Wednesday, Saturday. I told her one day to try, but she'll never do it. And I'm not saying I'm a great YouTuber, but I'm a consumer. And the company man, I've told you before, my favorite guy, company man, is my favorite. That's real, real good. The one guy's getting trolled on here. I saw his thing. What the hell is it? History. You know, people ripping on the guy. Because you get more popular on here, people go after you. The house goes out on the internet, and they rip on you and call you a pedophile. Look at, you know, the stalkers do it all the time. I mean, look at Sven Johnson. Not once, but twice. Why? Because a child went in the bathroom. The mom was, like, freaking. Grandma, I said, you go there. I'll go here. I lift him up, wash his hands, bring him out to his grandma or mom, and she's like, oh my God, thank you so much, because she was scared. And there's an accident. He calls a pedophile, really, by helping a child. So if you're in Boy Scouts, I mean, hey, I get it. You want to have that behavior, go for it. I know who I am, what I do for my community. I work for a living. I love coming on doing audios. It's fun, music in the background. I love doing my NFL shows. They're fun to do. My NHL one's growing. You know, making videos in my car, talking about people, whatever. People talk about me, but I'm better than other people. You know, I don't give you zero F's given. You don't like me. That's too bad, man. That's too bad. It's just too bad, baby cakes. But people are like that. Oh, my God. You know, he's this or that. Well, then why are you listening? Majority of people come to my show don't like me. And people have followed me over to Spreaker.com, which is fine. Get a basic mixer for $50, the one I looked at before. You get the headset I have on for $150, and you're at $200, then you got $8 a month. God, I know that costs money. I have my contract through 2022, 2024. I know that costs money. But you can do a 45-minute audio on YouTube and just leave it on here. I mean, 40-minute on here on Spreaker.com and build something, and people come listen. India loves me. I get it, man. But as soon as you want to cash those checks that they've wrote with their mouth, and you want to come to them in person and say, hey, listen, you are clear and present danger. Well, I'm going to call the police. They bitch when people take it offline, but they'll do the same thing to you. And like I said, people still listen to Tina D. And she gave Adderall to children. I mean, can I give those to your grandchild? I roll into your mobile home. Hey, man, dude. Oh, my God. I shall hope not, because it wouldn't be cool. But, you know, they just love the woman. They love her. Don't ask me why. I don't know. I still don't understand. Let me see. Mm-hmm. Let's see if Sam Johnson has done anything. No. What the hell's wrong with you? Sven Johnson, he shall not be named. I could talk about the stalker. I don't want to waste my time. He did a video. He did an audio about Super Bowl and mumbling and rumbling on until no one took Sven. Yeah, people did take KC, sweetheart. Chris Ransom did. It was not an upset. It's a 2-point game. Was the spread going either way? KC won. Happy for him. But the stalker is like, silence, half stoned of his mind. Oh, my God. Like, mumbling right along. He's a guy that buys jerseys and puts his name in the back. Still wants his butt buddy to come back. And, you know, I mean, but he's mumbling about 257. Literally stoned of his mind. Still, I'm surprised he didn't think it was Buffalo in there. I still loved it with the Atlanta guy. Buffalo lost? Yeah, they lost. You know, I'm far being pervert, I say. I was calling quarterback Murray this morning on the way to work. That's what I'm in my car, but whatever. I'm like, it hurts you, moron. But that's just me. But I'm sitting in front of my computer. I'm going to know what I'm talking about. It's just hilarious. I'm sorry, but sometimes I'm not being perfect. I mumble and rumble along, but I'm still not stoned. And running off with some guy. The parents said that, you know, she's mentally challenged and he's using her. That's weird. I'm sorry. You're supposed to protect these people, not use them for sex and other things, running around. If I was Snuggles, your author, sweetheart, just end it, man, because he's using you. Go find a man that cares about you and wants to better your life. She betters my life. I better her life. Me and my wife do. We better each other. We're equal. And if I was that... Again, Jamie C and Zane B were my friends. They are to this day. And I will always be their friends, especially me and Zane. We're very good friends. And we met out in Chicago. We chat occasionally. I know he's out of college, and I think he's in California working for somebody. Just a great guy. I mean, I bettered Chris Ransom's life. You know, we had a little misunderstanding, but I still support his ass. He just, I could not do what he does. But you enrich someone's life. You're hanging on the handicapped person. You know, I mean, I've worked with that Down syndrome guy down there who works on the McDonald's down there in Owatonna. Anytime I have a chance to go down there, I swing through in the morning, he's there, and I go, have you owned this place yet? Kind of looks at me. He's a really nice young man. He's like about, I don't know, he's 30 years old. Would I take advantage of the guy? Hell no. You don't take advantage of handicapped people. You don't. I'm sick and tired of reading about that behavior. It meant you help people, but there's a lot of mentally unstable people on this video panel are crazy, and this is their channel. This is where their friends are. That's who they. This is where their whole life is. YouTube. Oh, I want to be a sensational person. Get a good luck. You know, they see the pickle boys. They see the other idiot out there. Who are they? God, what's the other idiot out there? McJuggernauts guy. I think he's so great. These people are old news. That Mr. Beast is kind of cool. He has 8-minute videos. Smart. I haven't seen him, but guess what? He makes it fun. 8 minutes, 9, 10 minutes. But people, you can reach out and touch the food. And they wonder why, you know, they want to be accepted. It's kind of like, you feel like you're in school with these people, you know. Oh, I want people to like me. Oh, come on. I have my circle of friends in the real life, and then here very little. It's like, Jesus Christ, please get a job. Please, that's all I'm asking. Go online, work for a computer company. Do something. Go work for Burger King from your house. You just give your computer and say, hey, welcome to Burger King. They might be in Kentucky. I don't know. Oh, my God. Leave the house. Get a camera and go do something substantial. Zero F's given. Don't over-edit. Just do it. But it's hard to explain it when you're mentally unstable. Too many on. A lot of people on. Just absolutely insane.
I want to be someone's going to like me.
Oh, please. God. This is some chick the other day. I see some girl yesterday before, and she was whining about people not liking her or something. And she used the word community. I'm like, please. She's live. I just happened to see it. Like, oh, my God. I mean, like-minded people. Okay, that's what it is. Okay. But KC won. I'm happy for him. I'm happy and that they won. Let me think here. Okay. Let me see. Hang on a second. Oh, we got a voicemail, guys. Here we go.
And three saved messages.
Here we go.
New message.
Mm-hmm.
Subscribe, Dave 25.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
No one's gonna subscribe. See, there
Dave
it is. There is. Hang on a second.
Send LSD.
No, it was another one. He was like, "No one's gonna subscribe to your channel, bitch boy. No one's gonna subscribe to your channel." Let me see here now. Let me go hang up with him. No one's gonna subscribe. So he's the one that's stalking. See, there is no phone call. That's what it is. It's just, that's funny. So that makes me laugh. That's hilarious. That's funny. He's got nothing better to do. That's his problem. He's nothing better to do. But call. No one's going to subscribe to your channel. But he's got, right now, he's in the realm. I'm alive. The food's talking right now, and he's calling on a private phone over and over and over again. Over and over and over again. That's what he's doing. So. That's what he's doing. So that's what he's doing. Just constantly, constantly, constantly. So he'll call. He'll probably call again. Knowing him, he'll call again. You know. So he'll he's just sitting in his room right now, in his underwear in the sex room. You know, probably watching Man on Man, getting ready for the wedding tomorrow. Oh my goodness! But it is what it is. It makes you laugh. When I know I'm loved. I'm well beloved and respected. I guess right. You block phones. You block them on here on Spreaker. You block them on YouTube. It's a never ending saga. It's the way it is. You gotta deal with that behavior. You know. I know. I get it. You know. But it is what it is. Where it is, man. Yahoo, man. Things that you do if you're barely scraping by financially. I've never had to worry about barely scrapping, getting by. I've always gotten by. Eh? I don't know why you'd hang out with a handicapped woman. I mean, if you can hang out, with her, that's fine. But you don't run away with her and use her for sex. But that's just the way it is. Because I saw the article someone sent to me that she ran away with somebody. And that, you know, the parents said she's, you know, not all there. It's a shame. I've talked to her. She's like a nice girl. But if it's true and she's not all there, that's you're using somebody. That's not good, man. You're supposed to protect people, not hurt people. People are less fortunate. You make them fortunate by having a friendship. That's all there is to it. Okay? What's up? Oh, the girls are here. What?
What?
No. What time are you going to eat? Okay. What do you want? What do you want? What? Yep. Go away, little girl, before I beg you to stay. Get out of here. Time to go, little girl. Look at this shirt. Look at this. Mm-hmm. Go with your mama. Don't look at me. Go. Go. Go with your mama. Enough of your behaviors. Go with your mama. There you go. See you later. Bitch, please. Had to send her away. But yeah. That's just a stalker. I mean, I get it, man. Yeah, it's harmless, but just, you know, that soon goes away. But when you're run with somebody and, you know, whatever it may be, and you have nothing better to do. I get it, man. I don't know. I understand. You know, you don't have a job and you want to just hang out and cause havoc in chat rooms. And I told you before, ignore the stalkers. That's all you got to do. Don't, you simply just move on. But, you know, I mean, you have people like AZ, who's just nothing but a bold-faced little liar, worse than I am, and a con man. I've tried to tell that to people. The cockroach found that out the hard way. Sven Johnson found out the hard way. It's the way it is, man. I'm sorry. It's a fact. I'm not trying to be a dang, but I get it. Yeah, you're mentally unstable, but this is the worst place to be if you're crazy. You think you make friends here? Forget it. You got to get out of the house and do something substantial. Feeling sorry for yourself. I don't care who you are. It's never going to get you anywhere. And it's just the way it is, man. I get up every morning and leave 7 days a week, make money. I got to get some of my tips on money all over the place. I'm going to give her 20 for me and then 20 for the girl, $50 for shoes. I got to get the cards all signed up. I got one from the girls and two for the girls, and then one from the girls, one for the boy. So they each give her $10, and I give her 20, so she can get her shoes. So, but it's sad when your friendship circle is on here. It's just really sad. But anyways, the way she is, you know, people use the word family a little too much. That just drives me insane. You're my sis. You're my bro. It's not true. It's not true. They're not your sis. Okay? Not your bro. It's not a community. It's just a group of people that have like-minded individuals on here. You know, that's what con men do. That's the griper. It's to pity the highest. It's the way she works. But I laugh and I giggle and I cry and I scream and I holler. And it's the way it is, bitch, please. I don't know. What are we going to do, right? Not much.
All right, man, Yahoo. I did not have sexual relations with that woman, Miss Sawinski, Yahoo.
So, but it is what it is with this behavior that goes on here and all this stuff. And, you know, Donald J. Trump is, there we go, Sweet Melissa.
Hey, how are you?
Good. Welcome to the show. What's happening?
Not much. Can you hear me well?
I can hear you fine.
Excellent. So what's good tonight?
No, I just talking a little about stalking and other such behaviors. So that's what's going on. We talk on the phone about that behavior nonstop, skullduggery, you know, constantly calling the phone. He called already 3 times already. And I was just talking about this, the stalker and running with a handicapped child. And, you know, I've talked about the other stalker where he wanted to be son-in-law, I think, personally. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
I think because he,
I do.
Like I said, he sees what he saw in her was what he sees in him. You know what I'm saying? And he wanted to be fat boy's son-in-law, I think personally. But he wanted to marry her. And I think tomorrow is the official wedding date for these two people. They're gonna get married tomorrow. Mm-hmm. In downtown Boston, and then they're going to have a party this summer, I guess, at Fat Boys out there in Sydney. Because he offered up his assistance to be helping with his chat room, I guess. He wants to get good with him again. So, So he wants to, you know, offer up, and you know, I've been breaking down his audios and the ums and the ahs, and he sounds like he eats the mic all the time. I don't understand it, but you know. It is what it is. You know, you are who you run with on this video platform, and it's the way she works.
Sure. Yeah.
So,
I agree.
So what's your thought process? I mean, did you watch the Super Bowl yesterday?
No.
Okay, I didn't think so. I did, but I was just, That one stalker said was an upset. It was only a 2-point game. I mean, a 2-point thing. It was a good game. I had Philly, and I did 1:15 with Ted. I'm going to tell you something. After I saw Ted in Virginia, down there in Myrtle Beach, he almost died. He was helping on the road. You know, and he got run over. He got hit.
Oh wow!
And he died twice.
Huh. I didn't know that.
Yeah, he died twice.
And I had no idea that.
So he. He came back to life twice. He had to go to a lot of therapy. Both legs had pipes in, so he's actually getting around. But yeah, he died twice.
Wow. Wow.
So he's...
That's amazing.
I know. Right? The guy, he just... he like kept kicking back, and they pronounced him dead once.
Yeah. It wasn't his time.
No. Right? He's a little bastard, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
So anyway, so Donald J. Trump, that's one of our favorite kind of conversations here.
Yeah, right.
What's
going on now? You're going to have to...
he's in bed with the Saudis again. And what do you think about the crazy bitch from, what state was she from again? Woman from Atlanta yelling out in the white jacket, you know?
Oh, that was crazy, wasn't it? With the blonde hair?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's just it makes you laugh. It really does.
Yeah.
It's
a sideshow.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of like watching YouTube now.
Right. Oh yeah.
Let me inform you on the big buzz on the what do they call it? The Boit.
The Boit. Who's okay. Who's the Boit?
The Boit is the bottom of YouTube.
Oh yeah. Well, I call
otherwise known as Troll Avenue.
I call it the Titanic. I've always said lower part is Titanic, which we're on. That's how you want to put it. It's the Titanic. We're locked in the fourth floor. Yes.
Oh my God.
That's what it is. We are.
For sure. Well, this person supposedly who's part of the Boit has passed away at a relatively young age. This is reportedly at this point. 52 years old. Somebody I didn't know, I'd heard quite a few times, but I didn't know who it was. Mm-hmm. So they're all in this big tragedy. And, I noticed that the Weasel has made her own live stream. And of course, you know, she's a tragedy pimp.
Correct.
But do you remember the day that you had a live stream and you had a lot of call-ins?
Yes.
Do you remember that?
Yeah.
And for some reason, you had quite a few people.
Correct.
And they were pretty upset about somebody passing away.
Right.
And she came up and attempted to steal the show.
Right.
And just didn't care.
Right. Oh, that was... God. That was that guy. Oh, no. And then she was talking. And she was like, oh, honey. And she's doing her makeup or something.
Remember makeup. Right. But tonight, she's a tragedy pimp.
Right.
And she, of course, knew these people more than anybody else did. You know how it rolls.
All right.
And when I watched her video, I noticed that she commented, "Hey, Cal."
Yes.
Does she usually talk to you?
Not all. We did speak about a month ago. She had to call me out of the blue, and we talked for.
Yeah.
I talked to her. I'd love to have her on, but. She does not watch language like you do. I mean,
right.
I'm not saying I'm a prude. You know, me and you will cuss on the phone
I
together.
I love to swear.
I do
what
too.
Is appropriate.
But
what
when
is appropriate?
But when we're on a podcast, I ask is respect.
Right.
That's all I ask.
That's like running around in the grocery store swearing and yelling and
right.
You know what I mean?
I had a guy on my show yesterday. It was just me and him, but we were taught, and every three words was Effenheimer. I'm like,
I know.
I had to bring him back and get some passport. And we're going back, and I mean, I'm like thinking to myself, my God, you're worse than my brother. I mean, but every three words was something else I heard.
I know. I notice it. I notice it a lot on live streams.
Oh, my God. Well, it's
you know what I mean?
It gets old after a while. It's like, I get it. You know how to swear. I do too. But when I do my show, I mean, Ted will say F and I'm an Eagles. I'm sorry. That's cool. I get it. But when you just constantly. It's,
I know.
On these live streams, usually sex.
Like it's part of your vocabulary.
Right. It's
right?
sex.
Just to add it in.
It's sex or it's Effenheimer. Because people ask me about podcasting. Yeah, you can swear. I choose not to. Because once you put adult, it's not going anywhere. It's not going to be pushed out.
Yeah.
You can talk about sex. I get it. But
I just had to get a laugh out of the whole thing. That she, you know, like I said, implanted herself in the middle of it.
Oh yeah.
I'm like, wow.
The old weasel.
Never changed.
Oh yeah, she never. Like that one guy said, she used to be on New Year's Eve. I liked her back then. She was fun to talk to on the phone, but when Pago got hold of her, I'm sorry, Jackal. When you got hold of her, it all went downhill. And when it all went
I'm not going to blame him.
I can't.
Well, I think she has a long-standing problem, a very long-standing problem.
But you two made it worse. I think.
Oh, sure. But that's her life.
Right.
That's her life. Everybody she associates with. You know what I mean?
And like I'll say again, and I've said before, she likes music, and that's a stripper, like it or not. When she would do her live, she can't have music on. I dated a couple girls that were strippers on the side on weekends, and that was fine. That was cool. They never slept with the guys. I'm not doing it, but they were stripping to make extra money. They were decent, but they were the same way. We'd be sitting at home just talking, and she had the radio on.
Oh,
because she couldn't go without music, so she reminded me of the weasel. She was a nice girl. We dated for around 6 months, but she always had to have music on. We couldn't be in the car and just talk. Yeah. Music had to be on because she had to function with it. She couldn't function without the music because that was.
I can't sleep without a fan.
Right. Oh, I understand.
Even if I don't want it on me, I aim it towards the wall.
That's Sue Ellen for you. That's what she's. Yeah, Sue Ellen has it every day. We have it on every day.
Oh, yeah. The fan.
Either she's too hot or too cold.
Yeah. But the sound of it. You know what I mean?
Right. Oh, I understand. Totally understand.
Well,
I like
maybe that's it. Maybe
this fear mongering music that I have the background, it makes me think. Yeah. I like it.
Yeah. The stalking thing, I don't know if the internet has created it or if it's a personality that was already waiting.
Well, here's the deal. When you, life's before, I told this to a Desert Rose young lady. I don't know where she went. And I told this to a bathtub girl. Other women that I've dealt with, Debbie Daly has gone through it. Once you see the food, there was a radio show host here in town, 89.3, really nice girl, really great voice, nice little woman. We got back from a cruise, and she told me, she goes, yeah, we're talking about food. The guy had sent her an email, hey, my dog had passed away. So she sent back an email to say, I'm sorry to hear that. So what happens, the guy now gets involved, and she quit radio because he was going by her house.
Yeah.
Because the food responded. So he's heard the food. Now the food responded. So people see the food. Like me, as the stalkers do. I don't put their names in the notes anymore. I don't talk about, but my notes are prominently in there, but I respond back, I'm stalking. I don't call your phone. I don't call your house. I don't send you anything.
Yeah.
But I'm the a-hole because I respond in kind without saying their name. They can't handle
that. There seems to be an inability to let go.
Correct. I agree.
And that's something that they just can't move on. You know what I mean? And that's a problem.
Right. Oh, I know. It's
that's a problem.
Oh, I know. But, well, you know, like you said, so about the stalker, I talked to, so, what the hell, you say, ran away with the chick, you said?
No. See, that part I'm going to speak up.
Okay, go ahead.
But this was, I'm going to do this in his defense.
Right.
She was 16 at the time.
Okay.
So he was not with her. It was another.
I understand that, but he's still. Man. But she's. My point is, he's hanging out with a woman. My point to you is but he's hanging out with a woman who's in all this. I'm trying to say.
What it said in the article, because it went around everywhere.
Right.
That she was had a learning disability.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
We're concerned for her.
Right. That's what I'm saying. I didn't say misspoke. I misspoke. He did not run. My point is, he's hanging out with a woman. That is learning disability, which you shouldn't be doing. If you're going to do it, don't bring in the drama. Because he uses it for drama.
Yeah.
And that's a problem. She's a nice young lady. I've talked to her, but you don't bring her into this. Because this is his playpen. He doesn't work. When you don't work, you're 20 on, 4 off.
He doesn't have a job.
I know. He doesn't work.
No, I thought he did.
No, he used to. He lives in the basement. His grandma's on welfare. Like a lot of people on here, this is their playpen. This is their life. Who they talk to on here is their life. And that's what it is. And it is, I get it. I enjoy doing stuff on here. I enjoy talking about stuff.
But
I don't, you know, hey, I get my views. I get whatever I get on my videos. I get it. But at the end of the day, it's like, my God, get a job. Go do something. And
there's a lot going on in this world other than this.
Oh, I agree.
Right?
And people, and the only time they hear about any news is because they happen to hear it in a live stream. Not because they go read it.
Yeah.
It's whatever they hear in a live stream. But yeah, these live streams are just... It's just Effenheimer. That's why we don't listen to them anymore because they're just, It's like, I've listened to a few sports ones too as well. Every other word is just F this. I don't need to hear it. Give me what you're talking about. F this, yeah. F that, really? Because that's what people come on podcasts, so they can swear. Okay, we're happy for you. I've heard enough of that before.
Use racial slurs.
Oh, yeah.
Say that, you know, it's like, are you kidding me?
There was a teacher in town here for Eden Prairie. Okay, he's speaking to these high school kids about being on Twitter. All you have to say to them is very simple. All right, you guys, when you're on the social media apps, you guys, be careful what you say. Don't be saying any of the racial stuff. Yeah. What does he do? He drops the double G hard R to tell. Yeah. He says the word, gets an excuse. Well, North Minneapolis cancels on him, okay, after he's reinstated. Yeah. But I want to know what those kids are listening to over in North Minneapolis, what rap music they're listening to. You know what I'm saying? With the double G hard R. But all you have to say is say, hey, you guys, be careful on the internet. Watch what you say. Don't use any racial slurs. And be down with it. But you don't need to say the N-word because that's the excuse to say it. That's the excuse. No. Here it is. I'm going to say it.
Yeah. Foolishness.
I mean, look at the stalker. He's yelled the name out before. I don't know why. And
that's something that he's his trademark.
Yeah. He likes to yell it out. Don't ask me why. It's just like, because you know people do now play video games? They yell that out now. Instead of saying Effenheimer, they yell out the N-word. That's what they do.
What about if he's trying to get channels taken down, maybe?
Yeah, probably. Probably you know, just like porn bombing, same thing. Yeah, yeah, and whoever does that, you go back and block the IP. One thing I liked about Twitter, there was that one guy, I can't remember his name was. I sent him an email to tell him, and Jake the drunk talked to one guy. I can't remember his name
my
was.
God, that poor thing.
Oh God, he's being used too as well. Yeah, I've tried to help it. I don't even bother him anymore, but he was talking to somebody. I can't remember his name is. He's pretty well popular, but he got in a fight with somebody on YouTube about, you know, the truth, and the guy, you know, turned him in, right? And he got blocked whatever the hell they call this guy. I can't remember what his name is. So they blocked his IP. So he signed up on his laptop. So then he got his laptop and signed in. Uh-huh. I can't remember, but they detected his IP and they kicked him off. I tried to tell the guy, if you're gonna when you sign up on your old account, whatever, because they detected, they kick you off. They'll do that. They block IPs. Blog Talk used to do that. They used to block your phone. They would block your phone. They didn't screw around with you. If you trolled too much,
they should be that way, don't you think?
What?
I think it should be that.
Absolutely. I mean, I get trolling. I get it. But when you start.
Oh, sure.
If you start porn bombing people, you start dropping the double G hard R, find the IP, you go to the person that goes to the computer and finds all channels, and you're done. So if I'm out there, I have two channels. I'm out there trolling, saying bad stuff in the chat room, trying to porn bomb. Guess what? Two channels gone. That's the only way they're going to clean this place up. Uh-huh. And the only way it's going to clean up, and I get live streaming, but people just love to do that stuff. They love to sit on here. For G Mangos doing 3, 4, 5 hour streams, if it's Evil Anus just bitching the whole time because they have nothing better to do. Again, it's all night long, 20 on, 4 off. That's all it is. That's all it is.
That would wear me out, I guess, you know?
Well, I mean, because what they do is they'll do a 4 hour stream or a 5 and they go back and listen to it again. So that's a 10 hour day. You do it and then you listen to it back. That's what people do.
That's a good work day.
That's what they do. Yeah, like I said, I 6 hour stream the people have done. I can drive to Chicago and have deep dish pizza. I can fly out to see you.
Yeah.
I can fly out to see you and meet you at the airport by the time they're done. Do something in that time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's just not the mindset of a lot of people.
No, they don't get it. They don't get it.
There's so much going on other than bothering people and it is turning into stalking.
Oh yeah, I get it. The food's talking, and they want to talk to the food like me. They want to talk to me. I get it. I don't understand why, but you know.
I don't either. I don't want to know why.
I don't. I
really wouldn't want to be in that mind.
I think you've said before that it's an infatuation with old people. That Papa Grizz.
I did. It was older males.
Yeah, because he wants Papa Grizz to come back. That's his hero. I mean, I love to see him
come
back.
Come on.
You know.
Wasn't his, that particular person, it's like a love-hate thing.
Yep.
I forgot about him, you know, Grizz.
Right.
Until the other day. Well, I think came back and announced his health issues.
Yeah, well, that's fine, but
I'd forgotten.
Yeah, he's pretty funny when he gets mad. He's the best when he melts down. He's the best.
He was great for that. And if he had just realized that he was good for that, right, mm-hmm. and just turn it off and not take it so.
But
you know, threatened people himself. He threatened people.
Right.
He lied about you.
Yep. Oh yeah.
He lied about a criminal thing.
Yeah.
You know, all these things.
Oh yeah.
You know, we all knew that.
Right.
Anybody with half a brain knew that that was not your mugshot. That was not you. Right. So we all knew. The only thing I wish that Grizz would do is clean himself up.
I agree. Well, he's used his. I call them nieces. I'm sorry. I still think that's a brother. A brother, sister marriage.
Whatever it is.
I get my point, and he uses his granddaughter, his nieces as a weapon, and then uses them as a shield. Many times.
You know, if you don't want to go out and get a haircut, there are people that will come to your house and do that.
Right.
He looked so dirty, and he had a finger that he put up by his to scratch his face. And it was brown and crusty.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you don't. Well, look at the youngest pickle girl, Satan's granddaughter. They had to shame her. Remember, for 3 days straight to finally shower. Remember that?
Yeah.
Because she wouldn't shower.
Most girls at that age want to take a shower.
Correct.
All the time.
So, I don't.
It was like, oh, clean yourself up.
And I've said about pickle juice. Sweet young lady should be in a group home. I'm dead serious. That woman,
I know.
She has deteriorated. She's deteriorated the last 5 years to a child.
Yeah.
And it's too bad because, you know, again, like I said, one time when she was scribbling, remember in the back and he was mad?
Sure.
I said, you wish you would have everybody sent her pens
paper.
And paper to let her scribble. But he would, you know. Like I was telling somebody, I was so tempted to send him $1,000 for Christmas. I got some extra money,
don't
but I know that. But I told myself he wouldn't appreciate it and wouldn't say thank you. But I'm like, nah,
absolutely not,
no,
no, he wouldn't. I wouldn't. No,
well, he doesn't preach anything, anyways. He'd never preach anything. But he'd be my buddy again. He would unblock me. He'll do anything for money. He'll do anything for money.
Anything. He's a pimp.
Yeah,
he's a pimp.
And that's why the P.O. box is. The P.O. box he has is for money.
Oh, sure.
And just like Wonder House, she did a video I listened to a little while ago, and she said, I really took it personally that I was an e-beggar. I'm like, honey, when you have your stuff out there for money, you're an e-beggar.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, sweetheart. You're asking for money. You're an e-beggar.
Who was this she was saying? Who was this?
Yeah, Wonder House.
Oh, okay.
She was so disappointed. The vlogs are kind of funny. When she talks, because she hints, she's real good at hinting for things. Because then she'll do like every 6 months, she gets all kinds of fun stuff from people. But you know what she really wants is money.
Money.
Because she did her Christmas one, and she flashed $100 bills real quick. Someone gave her money. She has a room full of stuff, and I get it, people. I sent her Earls and a hat and a shirt, and I get that. But I told you before, okay, if I was going to send that woman money, let's say I was this kind of guy. I would not go through whatever the hell the thing is.
PayPal
because they take a percentage. Guess who my banker is? It's going to be simply the mail. I'll put it in an envelope and I'll send it to her.
King.
Right. She gets a whole thing instead of going through somebody else. But because she's the kind of person when she first, I understand she's a nude model. I get it. You would pay her $500 and she'd let you take pictures of her all. She was a fetish model. So she would. She's used to showing her ass, and she is another one. Carolyn RV had a bunch of calendars, and she can't sell them. It's like, no one's going to buy your calendar for $25, honey. No one's going to buy. I made my own calendar for running around 2023 and 2022 for my own house. I mean, I took my GoPro 10, and no one's going to want to buy my calendars. What the hell's wrong with you? But, I mean, people are too poor.
You know what? You're wrong. Your stalkers might want it.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, true.
You could make two sales right there.
True, right? Yeah, give them the calendar and be running around. I have to have my picture on there because they want a picture of the food once in a while. So that's what they want.
Exactly.
He'll
in your videos.
What?
You've had a lot of snow.
You see that?
We have had the mildest winter.
You see the last couple ones?
I did. I went through them. We did have that horrible cold snap. and it got to be like 30 below zero.
If you look at that blind ambition guy, he actually apologized on there about defend, because he went after me a few times that I was being a jerk towards AZ. He's realizing that the Ingrade is a liar.
But, you know, he could be suffering mental illness. And,
I understand that, but he likes to play that game. He's done that with people. He knows what he's doing. He knows exactly what he's doing, sweetheart. He likes to play the game.
I don't watch him. I'm not part of it. I remember when he came around, but I'm not like into that
right
stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They've had a big blow up on that channel for some reason. I don't quite get the whole thing.
Well, he likes to feel sorry for him. That's all it is. Then he turns on women, and then they're the cis, and it's like people after a while get. I mean, like I said, the best one was Pago when him and the Weasel did a triggered. Cause you know that's his channel. I know it is the triggered minds, and he's talking to Arizona. And exactly what I say, 1 minute you're this, and 1 minute you're that, and that's what he's always done. It's like it's what he's done, and it's just, I don't hate the guy, but I get sick of people when people sit to do the con man behavior. I hate it.
He's always just he screams and yells, and I can't listen to that, and I get lost in that. You know what I mean?
Right. So what do you think? Real quick, do you think I think Donald J. Trump? I did a video today. I put it out that. I think he's going to go third party, and then if he does, they're going to lose. He'll find a way to haul past some way out of this, but what do you think?
I do not think that he will become president again, honestly. I think it's going to be maybe that. I think we'll have a Republican this time.
Right.
You know, because everybody is just,
Well, they're realizing that poor choice, this idiot.
It was a very poor choice, but I think it was just the only choice at that time that people wanted out of.
Well, he's still pushing the narrative it was stolen election. That's never going to stop because he brainwashed. He's very good at brainwashing the white boys. You not agree?
Yeah, I agree.
He's very good at that behavior. He's pushed that. And I go on TikTok. That one guy who he's on TikTok and he with the Daily Show and he's talking to these two white women who could be your mother. Let's just say my mom. And there's two militaries. I'm like, really? And that's my favorite video. I still think these people are plants, but. These idiots, when he goes to these mega rallies, oh my God.
I know, it's crazy.
Come on, man. I get you like the guy, but it's a cult. Like one time somebody, it was this fad would say someone died to joke around with them. And the guy goes, honey, Donald J. Trump died. And she goes, our Donald? Are you serious?
Yeah.
And then someone writes, is this not a cult? You know, because the guy did it to her on purpose to see how she'd respond. So she comes walking towards him. Our Donald? He's dead? Are you serious?
Oh my God.
I mean, it's just this look on her face was like, but these people, they go to these mega rallies. I'm like, what is wrong with you?
I know.
What is wrong with you?
I remember my daughter had, she's older now, but my youngest daughter, she had dated this guy who was a real loser in high school. And he ended up on the front of the Union Leader, which is probably the biggest newspaper in New Hampshire. He was at a MAGA rally running down the road with an American flag draped around him. And I said, thank God he wouldn't stay with him.
Oh, my God. See, people are just strange. I get you like your politics.
Oh, my God, look who that is.
Yeah.
But, but that was his personality even back then.
Because he gets brainwashed. They latch on to something. That's how they get brainwashed. It's like drugs are. Same thing. You hang out. You you run with, I just see these people. I'm like, what the hell is wrong with you guys? I'm like,
absolutely.
They can't think for themselves. But people that hate Biden, but they want their tax money. They want their free welfare. You better get it to me.
That didn't work. You know what I mean? That didn't work. Whatever what they did at the time was... And that's all ending.
Right.
Everything is, basically ending. And COVID is still out there.
Right.
From what I understand.
It's still out there, but it's smaller, but it's like.
Yeah.
I just see these people at these, at what?
I've been watching a murder trial, the Alec Murdaugh.
Yes.
It's very fascinating.
Yeah.
And they had four jurors today show up with COVID.
Oh, really?
Tested, so. Yeah. So it's out there. It's alive.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I watched the Donald out, these idiots on TikTok, these
oh yeah. They love him.
I get it, but I don't understand it. You know,
it's almost like the way these two young guys feel about you.
Right. Oh yeah. They can't get enough. They're for obsessed. Some reason. Yeah.
Absolutely obsessed.
My name.
And it's really sad. You know, are they lacking in relationships?
I guess I have no idea.
Their fathers?
I have no idea. The two-ton one. He's driving his dad's Mustang around. He doesn't really, you know, he's the same one who harassed his grandfather, and it's on YouTube. Oh. He harassed his own grandfather.
I didn't know that.
Oh yeah. I mean, if I did that, oh my God, that's weird. It's weird.
It is really weird.
I mean, you harass your own grandfather?
What do you mean, crank phone calls or?
He was harassing him. It's out there. I was like, really? Why would I told him that? I said, what are you doing?
Why would you do that?
I don't know. I don't have no idea.
I don't know. Maybe that's the way that he's, you know, this bam. That's old crap. That
mm-hmm.
Remember Jackass?
And, yep.
You know, all that stuff. Maybe that. I don't know. I don't know.
Right.
I don't know. I couldn't tell you.
But I just think it's going to be interesting with a third party here. And I see it. Haley wants to run now, so the hunch is to get mad about that. He's mad about that. But he's going to go third party, you watch. And then and the plagiarists will get back in. Because they're...
Yeah. I hope not. I really, you know, I'm over this Biden stuff.
Oh, I'd love to see him step aside. I'd love to see him step aside. Mm-hmm. We need fresh meat in there for both sides of the aisle that come the middle.
Yeah.
Because the idiot down in Florida, I call him the human trafficker. Because if I would do that, doing that, we'd be in jail.
I know.
You'd be in jail.
I know.
You're human trafficking with people. Put them on a plane, make promises the way they go. Oh, my God.
That was bizarre, wasn't it?
He's still going to do it. He's still... Same thing in Texas. Same in Texas.
They're okay. Well, they support him. They're okay with that. And they're worried about Mexicans. We, you know, who's going to clean the hotel rooms?
Yep, I agree.
The strawberries and the lettuce and, you know, all the things that white people don't
do. Yeah, exactly. I worked Super 8. When I worked at Super 8, the Mexicans would come in, the Latino girls, and I'd have to kick them out. I'd walk in there. It was like... tampons, everything. Oh, they're like a sex party in the whole nine yards. I'd come back 20 minutes later, look like nothing happened. Nothing happened. They were that good. We had a couple Guatemalans who had Perkins that was, I told the guys to keep doing prep because she couldn't speak up, but she wasn't stupid. She lasted 6 months because she just said no moss and left because she would come in, the place was, she was the best prep cook I've ever seen in my entire life. Mm-hmm. If they just took care of her and did their stuff, she'd still be there. She was the best prep cook I've ever seen in my life. Her onions were perfect. Her buttermilk was perfect.
Why don't they go pick the strawberries?
Yeah, they won't do it.
Maybe, you know, the stalkers can go do that.
Give me a break. But anyways, I'm going to go have some talk. Anything that you want to discuss down the... Do I know this person that allegedly died or what?
I don't think so.
What's the name?
I'll explain it to you after.
Okay, no problem. I understand.
Okay.
And we'll talk to you tomorrow. Thanks for my apology. I appreciate it. I'll talk later.
Okay.
There she goes. Bye. Sweet Melissa. Thank you very much. Coming on the show. Anyways, you guys, my name is Jeff, and it was disappointed in my... I can't do my favorite stuff anymore. I love Eyes of Glory. But the Air Force, the Army, and the Marines, the Navy, and the Merchant, NASA, thank you so much through this country. Without you, nothing at all. Want to give me money to share it? That's all I'm asking. But yes. Well, we appreciate you guys showing those beaches. Men, women, blue. Balls the size of bath of oak trees. Thank you so much. And the men and women of the workforce, thank you so much. That work hard for us every single day. We appreciate it out there, you guys. Practice safe sex. We don't want to avoid having children out of wedlock. That's all we're asking, okay? That's all I'm asking. Okay? That's all you got to do. Put a condom on. And don't drink and drive anytime you're going to murder someone. This was a presentation of Fear Mongering Radio with Sweet Melissa at the end. Stalk all you want. It is what it is. You all behave yourselves. Arizona Ingrade, you're nothing but a con man, a liar, bold face. From the outskirts of Portside, Minnetonka, the ones the stalkers all want to get in my panties. Keep on trawling. We will see you soon. Bitch please, and I mean bitch please, and I am out.